Heyo everybody, Haku here with my live reaction to the new, well, I guess the first new Walking Dead issue of this year. So it's going to be issue 162 and the final part of the Whisperer War. Now, I've already said I kind of feel like the Whisperer War is going to spill over into the next volume. Maybe not necessarily a war anymore, but I feel like if they're going to kill off the Whisperers or end that threat this issue, they're going to have to do a shit ton this issue. So I don't think they're going to do that. I think the storyline, the war may be over, but the storyline will continue, I feel. But yeah, let's just see what we got here. Any predictions for what will happen? No idea. A lot of people are saying, oh, it's got to be a big death, right? Yeah, I don't know. I have no clue how they're going to play this. And even then, a big death, I'm not even sure who. A lot of people have been guessing Andrea for a while, and I could kind of see that because she hasn't really done much for me as a character in a while, so I'd actually be kind of okay with that. But we'll see how things go. And there was something else I wanted to say before I got into reading this, but I don't remember it, so let's just go ahead and go. We have the cover here, The Walking Dead, The Whisperer War, Part 6 of 6, 162. Yo, we got the Whisperers and Andrea on the cover. Alright, let's move along. Feels like it's been so long since I've read an issue of The Walking Dead. I'm sorry, says Negan. And we see the sun is rising, see a shovel in the ground. Is this a burial for Lucille? I hope you're at peace. I hope you're in heaven, and you fell in love with someone who treats you better than I ever did. And that they're fucking your brains out and then fucking your brains back in after that on a daily basis. I'm hoping this is the next best thing. This is the closest I can get. I never got to bury you before. I know this isn't the same. I'm sorry, you were never truly put to rest. Yo, and we're getting some of that Negan backstory callbacks here. I'll always miss you, Lucille. I'm sorry I named a stupid fucking baseball bat after you. And then he loses his smile again. We will leave you behind, says Dwight, yelling over. I'll catch up, says Negan. Then we see, it looks like, is that William leading the charge with his men? Oh man, this guy just keeps getting more badass. I freaking really love William. Yes, sir, says one of the knights in the back. I think it was Taylor. We're almost there. I wanted to reach the hilltop before sunrise. We gave the horses too much of a break overnight. They'll make it. What? We're pushing the horses too much. I don't know. I'm reading backwards. Sorry, guys. So much reading right to left that I forget. William, did I mess up on the first page then? No, I didn't. There wasn't any horizontal panel. So much. So sorry, guys. William, slow down. What? We're pushing the horses too much. I don't know how much longer they can stay at this pace. We're almost there. I wanted to reach the hilltop before sunrise. We gave the horses too much of a break overnight. They'll make it. Yes, sir, says the knight in the background. Whoa, says William, slowing down. Guess they ran into something finally. Oh, man. That looks kind of like an overpass sort of area. I'm trying to see if it's the same area that Rick was at when he first saw the hilltop, but we see it burning in the background, the walls all torn down. It feels like it is all torn and burned, but it feels like there's still enough left there that they could repair it eventually, honestly. It would take some time, but they could repair it. My God, they must be. William, look. Huh? My word. Hey, and we see the hilltop survivors waving over. Looks like, it's Dante. Where the hell were you guys 4 hours ago? Alright, don't see anybody I particularly recognize here. I'm so sorry we weren't here. It isn't your fault. Could have just as easily been the kingdom that got hit, says Maggie. What can we do? Maggie, seriously, whatever we can do, we'll do it. Some of the horses got loose. If you'll loan me one of yours, I can find them. When the fires die down completely, we're going to sift through and see if there are any supplies left. Then we're headed to Alexandria. Hopefully they've fared better. They got the majority of both your and my forces, so they better have. You've sacrificed a lot for their safety, says William. And we will be repaid, says Maggie. I knew the risks. This is what we do. We help each other. What will you do? He says. We're going to rebuild. Same as we did with Alexandria. We'll make this place better than it ever was. See, like I said, they can rebuild. They did it with Alexandria. It's what these people deserve. You know, I like Maggie so much as a character. Lydia, you okay? Says Carl, walking over. No, none of us are. Look around. It's horrible. But we survived. We're going to be okay, says Carl. Not all of us. What are you talking about? You don't understand. Oh, bullshit. You can tell me anything. This isn't the first time my people have done this. The Whisperers? The things we've done. I've never been on this side of it. I've never had to see the aftermath, what we left in our wake. I was a part of that. For so long I did. The things I did to complete strangers. I hurt so many people. I killed. If you knew all the things I did before, you'd hate me. What? What is it? This? It's not easy for me either, says Carl. What? I could say the exact same thing to you. You don't know what we did to get to this place, the things I did along the way, to survive. So our people could survive. But we did them, the horrible things, to get here, to get to this life with these people, where we don't have to do things like that anymore. Now we remember those things we did, not to. We don't let them make us terrible people. They remind us why we fight so hard to be good, so we never have to go back to that, so that we never have to do those things again. So we can be happy, he says, putting his arm around her. This is nothing. We'll get over this. This is just a hiccup. As long as we don't change who we are, we still... What are you... Just shut up and hold me, Carl, she says, hugging him. See? The whole I don't love you thing. Like a lot of people are saying, it's gotta just be a play. And we see Beto with his men, still looking pretty injured. I've got you, says the one dude. Just sit down. Rest for a moment. Catch your breath. You're not back to full health yet. Maybe we should slow our pace to something more reasonable. No, says Beta. We can go faster. I can do it. We can't wait any longer. This has to be done now. So this may be the only way I'm seeing to end the Whisperer War in this issue, or to end the whole Whisperer storyline, is to maybe just have Beta sort of self-destruct them. Like, if he pushes himself too hard, that could be the end of their strategy and could get them killed like that. Just tell me one more time, says Rick, just so I'm sure. Two rapid shots for a herd, three rapid shots for the saviors, says Andrea, presumably talking about the signals. And we see it looks like people in the back pruning trees, either that or collecting fruit. You doubting me? Not at all, just making sure I've got it straight. Oh, please, this old man Rick act is getting old. You're barely 40 years old. I'm only 38, says Rick. Damn, Rick is looking hella old to be 38. What the heck? I worry, okay? I'm second-guessing myself so much these days. Being behind these walls, it's making me soft. I can feel it. Soft? Are you fucking kidding me, says Andrea? How many months ago did you fight off two men who tried to kill you? Whether you like it or not, honey, you've still got it. Listen to us. This is how we talk about the death of a human being now? My God. I know. This is our world now. Being used to this. This is life. The toothpaste is out of the tube. I don't know if there's any coming back from this. Then what are we doing? Says Rick. It's Eugene. Open the gate. And then we see Siddick. I'm on it, opening the gate. Special delivery. I wanted to make sure we had a good supply, no later than today. We worked night and day to get this shipment ready. Whatever is coming, we'll be prepared. Welcome back, says Rick. Good to... Yo, shit, and then Eugene falls off the, I guess he's just tired, since he's been working all night and everything. Falls off the coach. Help me, get him to the ground. I got it. Eugene, sorry. Sorry, I haven't slept. I wanted to make sure this ammunition got here by morning. I wanted to. Just rest. You did it. It's here. You took a big risk here. What if you'd blacked out on the open road? Wow, you guys must have been working yourselves to death. This is a lot. This was the only way I could contribute. It's important to me. Look around. You really think we're eating bread and using electricity and running water and all the other things you keep going here and thinking, what's Eugene contributing? You contribute plenty. I probably read that wrong, honestly, I think. I just mean defense. That's the most important thing. Comfort, sure, but that doesn't make us safe, says Eugene. You know, if you had to make people here choose one or the other, they'd probably... And then they hear a gunshot. That's Andrea. One shot, though. Just one. Ah, and we see Dwight and Laura are back with the rest of their army. See Annie at the gates greeting them. Michonne's back. Jesus. Magna. Damn. Holy shit, says Rick. They did it. Yo, so the army's gonna be there when the Whisperers presumably attack. What in the hell? It's over, says Dwight. Nicely done, Dwight, says Rick. I sure as hell didn't do it alone. Yet, never quite works out that way, does it? It's so great to see you, says Andrea to Michonne. It's great to be back. And then, it looks like Annie hugs Jesus. I'm so glad it's over. You and me both. Good work out there, says Siddick. Thanks, says Magna. Okay, I get it. I see where I stand, says Negan, just standing in the background. We lost a few. Haven't heard from Father Gabriel. We have to assume he didn't make it at this point. You never know. We'll search the area once the dust settles. Come with me. Tell me everything, says Rick. We thought we'd handled the bulk of their numbers when they hit us with a second wave. We split into groups, mixed in amongst them, without them knowing it. We killed the Whisperers among them who were steering the herds, then took out the dead systematically. It wasn't easy, but we got it done. You sure you got them all, says Rick? Beta was nearly beaten to death, but he got away. He's still out there. He was apparently their second in command, appears to be leading now, though there's none left to, lead. You're sure? Yes, I'm sure. You want to ask me again? I know when a job is done, Rick. They hit us with everything they got. I'm sorry, but after everything I saw, it's just... This seems too easy. You know, Rick calling it. Rick still knowing what's going on. Easy. Trust me when I say it was anything but. They had hundreds of the dead at their disposal. It was quite an undertaking. You know, then Rick looks at him. Did you say hundreds? You know, Rick knows that it's in the thousands. Probably almost 1,000. There were tons of them, said Dwight. Oh, God. Rick, what's wrong? Where are you going? You have to get back out there. What are you talking about? It's done. We won. No, we didn't. I didn't see hundreds. I didn't see 1,000. I saw thousands of them. A sea of the dead that roared like an ocean. You would have heard them screaming towards you. It wouldn't have taken days to steer them away. Killing them? I don't even think killing them would have been possible. Trust me, they're still out there. And then Dwight looks butt-fucked. Oh yeah, they are seriously and sincerely boned. There is a sea of walkers coming towards Alexandria now, and we only have a couple pages left. It seems like we as readers are boned until next month's issue. I think next month is the double issue, though, I think, right? I don't know. Let's continue. Look at this art. That is a sea of the dead. Wow. It is done. They can make it the rest of the way without us. There's no stopping them now, says Beta. Yo, so Beta doesn't even, like, care. He set them towards Alexandria, and now it's just the Whisperers can go do whatever. Alexandria's boned. Our war is over. Let the dead finish what we have started, says Beta. That is a great panel of Beta as well. I really like that. And that's probably going to be the end, isn't it? Yep. Welcome back to the first issue of The Walking Dead in 2017. As the war ends, the Whisperers go nuclear with a horde of walkers. Alpha's threat from the end of 143 is finally unleashed, and there's really no preparing for it, right? It's going to be insane. Make sure you come back here next month for 163, which will be 25 cents and longer than usual. Wow, nice. And 164 will also ship in February. Yes! So now we get two issues in February, which is going to be great. And we're going to see what happens with this freaking horde, this massive horde, because I don't even know, like, yeah, I honestly have no idea what the characters are going to do here, unless they go put on walker skins and go whisper themselves. Like, that is the only way I see out of this, because for thousands, I don't think there's any wall that can hold them back. I don't think there's enough bullets in the world. Even with all that Eugene just made for them, I'm not sure they have enough bullets to put down all of them before getting overrun. They are just pretty boned at the moment. And I don't know how they're going to get out of it. But either way, I thought this was a pretty successful live reaction. And I'll have my review of this chapter up, or this issue up, tomorrow. Hopefully, as usual. And that's it. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. And I guess like if you did like the video, and comment down there to tell me what you thought of this issue and what you thought of my first thoughts and reaction to it. I really loved it, but you know I really loved all of the Whisperer War. I kind of, honestly, like, it feels like a lot of the Whisperer War, we haven't actually been at the war, and a lot of what's coming next seems more battle heavy. But either way, who knows what'll happen. Subscribe for more The Walking Dead, both comics and TV show, and a bunch more. Follow on Twitter if you want. I'll try to keep you updated there and stuff for the channel. That's it. So thank you once again for watching. I'll see you all next time.